some project, we are thinking that, okay, this is my project and this authorship will come to me and this will only beneficial to me. If you think like that, then the other's work will be will have no importance to you, right? So if you think in such a way that my work will make this lab in a higher position, then you will give the importance to other work also, because other work also make your lab in a higher position. Discuss with the lab mates before going to supervisor. And every small, small problem, you should not go to the supervisor. Our lab mates are there, postdocs are there who are very trained in that field. You can talk with them, you can discuss with them. In discussion, your problem may get solved. So you are spending 40 to 15 hours in the lab in a 24 hours day. And if you don't have good relationship with your lab mates, then your lab will be hell. So you have to, and you have to force you to go in the lab. So you have to be manage it. You have to make a good relationship with your lab mates. So how you can make? So there are several points. Point number one: try to feel your lab mates as your family members, and give some personal time outside of the lab. It will help you to understand the person, as well as it will increase the friendship. Point number two. Try to help your lab mates, assist them in their work without expecting much in return. Because if you expect something, then what will happen, that will you may not get and you will be unhappy. And unhappy mind will not work better. Point number three, give some positive suggestion very friendly and politely when your lab mates are doing something wrong according to you. Point number four, leave all your ego and accept your mistake with a happy mind in a smiling face. Give importance to other words and try to judge yourself, not others. Point number five, don't be afraid to your senior and don't be frightened to your juniors. Because if there's a fear between two persons, then the cooperation cannot happen. And without cooperation, the lab cannot give a best productivity. So, and remember that the respect and the fear are not same. Point number six, don't complain to your supervisor against any of your lab mates. And it's better to discuss with your lab mates to solve the problem. So cooperation versus competition. Cooperation is something which always increases the positive environment in the lab. And competition is something which always creates a negative environment in your lab. So cooperation is very important to increase the productivity. And when somebody is uncooperative in your lab, the whole system will fall down. Because it is just like a cycle stands in the same rally. If one cycle falls down, means all cycle will fall down. So it is the same way. And in this case, I want to mention the movie what happened, the hockey, the women's hockey team won the championship. When each of the members are covered, and until unless they didn't get the trophy. Okay. So we also try to do something great means we should be cooperative with each other. And moreover, the competition, so-called friendly competition also causes negativity and strained relationship in some environments. And lack of cooperation for any reason has the same output, is the productivity will drop. In 1986, Dean Joswald, the professor of Simon Fraser University in Canada, found the cooperation instead of a competition leads more successful researchers and skyrocketing productivity. So make good relationship between your lab members, make your environment and your mind happy, and a happy mind always works better. Rule number four, everyone is doing job just important as everyone else. Everybody is doing work as same importance. Okay, so nobody is different. In the lab, there is no hard hierarchies, and everyone is equal. There should not be any favoritism. Okay, that all lab members should be equal. Because favoritism provides a negative environment and makes you unhappy and demotivated, which decreases the productivity. And we sometimes misunderstand that our professor has some favoritism and somebody may be his favorite student. But it might not be, because professor have to make important decisions. He may choose someone to do some job in that moment. But the next moment, it may be you. So don't misunderstand that there is a favoritism. I always try to discuss important discussion with everyone, my students involved. A productive lab needs not to be negative environment, says by Professor Fernando in the Nature article. So point number five, we should never expect anyone to do the same as we do. everyone has their own working style, and we should not specialize anyone to do work as I am doing. So everyone has different style to do work, different time to do work, and I want to read this para because it's very important by the Fernando, Professor Fernando. So what he told, I have worked long hours and have been extremely stressed many times during my career. I usually woke up early and start working while everyone at home is sleeping. But that work family balance works for me. I devote my afternoons, weekends and public holidays to my family. I take a full month of holiday during the summer. Everyone in my lab should find a balance that works for them. So in that way, he got the work-life balance. But for somebody case, early, coming early and going very late night and not coming the weekends and taking 1 month holiday may not be the suitable way to do work. Somebody work throughout the year but coming late every day. So that may be his own style. One day, one of my experience. One day one of my senior told me that he is perfect. And he told me make myself also perfect. We both have different ideologies. We both have different views. We both have different styles to do job. Now what is perfect according to him, for me it is totally opposite. And as he told to become me perfect, what will happen? And I started doing work according to my perfect view. But it was not matched with his view and he started scolding to me. Then I realized nobody is perfect. Perfect is a relative word. And everyone is different. Everyone should have the independence to do their job according to their own perspective. But it does not mean that you can do anything. There are some basic rules you have to maintain. A police officer always maintains the rules of a constitution, but there is a difference in the way of their investigation. So try to understand each other, work style, and stay together and be happy. Rule number 6, never compare anyone with anyone else. We should not compare because everyone is different. We don't know the situation in which somebody else is. So everyone's situation is different, means we are different fruits. So we should not compare with an apple with an orange. And we are all a different fruits, so we should not compare with between us. Here I want to quote one line which was written in NCERT guidelines. This kind of practice only humiliates the students and lowers their self-esteem. So researchers should not compare anyone with anyone else, but rather than they should compare himself, means own with himself. So every research scholar should compare himself, what he is in today and what he was in yesterday. It will make him better. Researchers' previous knowledge and experiences need to be acknowledged and used to develop the learning. Here you can see one picture. Here, in a bigger world, a small fish, and a small world in a bigger fish. Now, who can move first? We can say the small fish can move first, but the reality may not be that. So, this smaller world, this is the surrounding, this is the environment of this big fish, inhibits the big fish to move first. So, everyone has different question paper in their life, and they have different answer for them. Don't try to copy any other answer, because it will be wrong for you. So stop comparing yourself with others, be happy, focus on your job. Sometimes people around you won't understand your journey. They don't need to, and it is not for them. And the point number 7, this is the last point, that we all have deadlines to do something job, right? Because our PhD is 5 years timetable, and we have to work hard and for a long time because life will not give you extra time. But this should be an exception, not a rule. We should not carry this hard work throughout our life because then we will lose our personal life, which is much more important. We must have a life outside of the work. Suppose whatever work you are doing, maybe some disaster may come and all works can go in the dustbin. And then what you will do? When the all world is against you, your family, your good friends may support you. So you should maintain some outside of the work life. That is very important. And working long hours and the weekend working the weekend should be discouraged. Happiness is an internal matter. So if at the last I want to say 3 things. First one is this, happiness is an internal matter. If we give some outside source of happiness, the source may be destroyed. But source